this particular question, I had to do some more research on. I'm getting confused trying to code ALIF in ICD-10-PCS. It seems so different from ICD-9 volume 3 codes, and it is very different. First thing we need to know is, what does ALIF stand for? ALIF is an anterior lumbar interbody fusion procedure. All right. And so an additional question that was written similar to this, because when you guys send in the questions, we try to combine them. So it was unique that more than one came in. It says, how do you code for an ALIF with a diagnosis of grade 3 annular tear L5 through S1 and a grade 2 annular tear L4 through L5? Now, they were wanting to know also the PCS portion of this, which is the ICD-10-PCS that replaced the volume 3 ICD-9 codes. So let's talk about the procedure real quick. I actually found some fantastic information from Spine Health. It's on spinehealth.com, and there is a link that you can use from this answer sheet. But one of the things that you need to know about ALIF procedures, and again, we shorten everything down to an abbreviation, right? Because nobody wants to have to say anterior lumbar interbody fusion. But ultimately, what you're doing is you're fusing the vertebra together, okay? Because it has wear and tear on it. And that cushioning that's between the vertebra has worn out, and so they have pain. So now that we know that that's what is being done, there's two approaches that are used. And when you're doing PCS, you need to know the approach, right? And commonly there's an anterior or in the front. They actually go through the abdominal wall and go to the spine. They actually move aside the abdominal contents, because actually all of your intestines and all those organs are kind of in a sac. So they just kind of bypass that, pull that out to the side, and then they go right into the spine, right? And then, or they could do a posterior fusion, but really they like to go in from the front, because that's where the damage usually is the front of the vertebra. And then anterior way, they'll go in and they can put pins and do some other things. I've got some more visuals for you, but know that they can do an anterior and a posterior fusion. And so that's going to make picking the proper PCS code important. In the case when there's not a lot of stability, this is actually a type of degenerative disc disease. So when you're coding out for regular ICD-10 codes, you know, that's probably what you're dealing with. But for the ALIF procedure itself, the first thing is anterior or posterior fusion or both. So as we scroll down, and we know now what the procedure is, let's break it down, because PCS is actually brilliant the way it's set up. To me, it's a lot easier to use than volume 3. There's once you get the hang of it, PCS is like taking those little wooden blocks that your children played with, you know, with the letters and stuff, and just putting the blocks in order to write a code, to tell a story. It's so much fun. So the first thing you need to know is, what is operation? What is the procedure that's being done? Well, we're doing a fusion, okay? So when you go to look in the index of the PCS, you're going to look under fusion. You're actually going to fuse something together. Then they want to know, what body system are you working with? Well, this is considered a joint. A lot of people don't realize that. So then you have to know, if it's a body system, it's considered a joint. What is it? Well, you have 5 lumbar vertebra, and then you have 5 sacral vertebra that are actually fused together, but they count out as 5. They start at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lumbar, and then it goes to the sacrum, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but they're fused, okay? So that's important when you go to take care of making the code, putting all the pieces together, not necessarily for PCS, where it's L5 or whatever, but asking yourself where you're at in the joint. And then you need to know if there is going to be a device used, right? And there's usually a device. So three choices of the devices are interbody fusion device, where they actually go in and put a cage, a titanium cage that holds that vertebra in place. And then this, then they can also take a bone graft from the iliac crest of the pelvis, which, you know, is that the, like the heart shaped part of the pelvis, the, you know, you need to know the bones of the body, guys, if you're doing coding. So that iliac crest is how they can tell if it's a male or female skeleton, right? By the shape. So they actually tap in there, pull out, part of the pieces of the pelvis, and they graft in that substitute tissue to make new bone fusion. And then they also have something that's not from the body. Auto means that it's coming from your body. And then if it's not from your body, they're getting it from someplace else. But here we're showing the lumbar and sacral joints, I guess you can say, part of the vertebra, and you see where the facets are. We're dealing with this procedure, like I said, they come in from the front. So see the blue areas, which is that that it says it's the inner vertebral disc area, and that's the part that's deteriorated and being squished. And then the spine, you know, all the nerves and stuff are involved here. But see where it says the facet of the joint, that's where you're getting that these are joints. Okay, so this is a picture of the vertebra or the lumbar and the sacral area that we were just talking about. Okay, and they're going to come in from the front, which would be the blue area that you're seeing. It was very difficult to find a picture that we could actually get permission to use, you know, but this was absolutely perfect to show you what they do. So now as we scroll down and we know what the basis of our code is, right? Let's look at how this would be coded. So if you have a PCS manual and you can keep up with me, you can follow along. The first thing we're going to be is in section O, and that's medical and surgical. So think of that as your first little wooden block. Then they want to know
zero, not O.
Thank you for, yes, thank you. And this is another thing to, when you're dealing with ICD-10, it's always a good idea to strike through zeros to kind of keep them in shape. Thank you, Chandra. So what body system is our next little block? And that would be an S for lower joint. Okay, and then the root operation is going to be a fusion, and as you are looking in the table to fill in these blocks, that would be a G. Okay, the next portion is to go into more depth of what actual body part are we dealing with. Well, the one that I chose to just simplify everything, lumbar vertebral joints, two or more. Okay, so that's a one, but there's other choices that you can use. So we're going with that one. And then the approach, well, it would be open, because what they do is they literally open you up, pull everything to the side, and go into the spine like we saw in that picture towards the little blue areas. That's the front of the anterior part of the spine. And then where you see the little knobs, that's the posterior part of the spine. Okay, so what I did was I actually pulled out a find a code from this point. The code that I picked so that we could have an example was OSG10. That's where we're showing right there that we've got as our basis of our code. But then we have some other choices that we've got to make. This is where the options open up. And this is where a lot of the confusion can happen. And as you are more familiar with the procedures and how the terminology is used and the different ways they do these procedures, this is where this part of the code starts to pop for you, okay? So if we use this this OSG1070. You've got fusion of two or more lumbar vertebral joints with this tissue from the your own body. Substitute anterior approach, that means from the front, anterior column, open approach. That's the 70, right? Okay, and this was, again, so much information that I wanted you to get to see, so it's kind of small. So just real quickly, look at all of your options, though. We go from 70 all the way down to a ZJ, which is fusion of 2 to 4 lumbar joints post approach. Let's see, open approach, but anyway, you may be able to see it better than I have. I would have to put my glasses back on. But see all of the options that they're giving you here off of this one code. Now, don't let this freak you out, though, because it's all right there in the manual. What you have to do is just pick the right block piece to go to fill out this code, and it's going to be in your terminology that you find in the procedure itself, in the op report. Okay, but again, when you get to a new base code, like I said, before the 70, then you get another list of these. And I think, did I write something else under after that? I think maybe I did. Okay, so then I said, here is an example. We were talking about lumbar, right? But what if they also did part of the sacrum? Then that would be OSG as that foundation part of the code with 504Z, which would, and again, I just pulled this out as one of them. There's several options, but here we're doing a fusion of part of the sacrum, and it's an internal fixation device, open, okay? That's another way that another option that's given to you. It's very fascinating. It's a lot of fun to work with PCS, but until you get in there and start doing it, those little blocks can get very confusing. And the hardest part, though, is by far figuring out what the first term to look up is. And it's a fusion for this particular PCS code. And then the blocks all start to fall into place literally for you. So this was a fun one.